Right, we're going to do a 5 kilometer loop, basically up here, because obviously the roads in Bali are horrible for running, you know. That's why one of the reasons George moved to Sasse was so that he could run in peace, because it's pretty dangerous.
I've not done much running though.
But we've got the boys here. Everyone say what's up.
Yo.
Little run club, Friday morning, and then we'll get a nice coffee and a coconut up there.
Nice.
So 5km loop. George has just paid like a Gojek driver to transport juice on the back of the bike, so we'll get some sick rolling shots, won't we, Juice?
Oh yeah. How long have you been doing this for when you were back here? I know it's the first time.
I did it every week.
Every week? Every Friday?
Yeah. Sometimes we had like 20, 25 people.
That's sick.
So good.
I like it.
And it's actually funny because all the guys that come here, like 50 or 60% of them end up joining my creator club as well.
Yeah.
So it's nice. Yeah. I think when people get to meet you in real life, they feel like a stronger connection. It's like when you with the Physique Academy boys.
Oh, yeah.
When you go and do the trips in Lanzarote and shit.
Sick. I got one of my guys coming out on Sunday.
I think it makes everyone feel so much better.
Yeah, definitely. I like it. I like it. How long are you here for?
Only till Monday.
Only till Monday?
Yeah. But me and George are playing paddle tonight as well, which I'm buzzing for. 8 o'clock. And then in October, I'll be coming back.
All right, sweet. Nice. I've got another one. Got
yes, bro, how are you?
Right, how are you?
George.
George,
nice to meet you, man.
Huh? Say hello to the camera.
Oh, sorry, did I just jump in?
Yeah, it's good. It's good, bro. It's natural.
Good.
It's natural.
How are you, bro? Good to meet you.
All right, well, let's get crack-a-lacking then. Let's get it done.
O'clock. It's a little bit hotter than...
I was like 9. I was like, shit. It gets hot, man. But, you know, it's 5K. We'll be fine.
Let's get it done.
Yeah.
Pleasant to see you, boss.
Yeah, man.
You too, mate.
Let's go.
Good morning, everyone.
We're done and dusted. Nice light 5k to start the day. A little bit too hot for my liking at this time, but yeah, it's nice to connect with some lads, talk all things business, mindset, getting jacked. What a fucking life, man. Literally paradise. So yeah, probably gonna potentially jump in the sea, cleanse the body, get all this fucking salt off me. And then we're gonna have some breakfast, some coffee. So, 2 rounds in, first set, 20 reps on the barbell squats, then second set, 20 reps on the barbell squats. We're in, 10 minutes in, 400 meter run.
You got the best.
Not pain, no gain. Slaughter this shit. Going out in a fucking a body bag. This is gonna be a crime scene, lads. Absolute crime scene. The only dead body will be mine. It's a beatdown. It's a throwdown. It's an annihilation. I better shut up now, because that's not an annihilation. Annihilating people's minds with shit talk. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Come on. Come on. Oh, one more. Woo. Motherfucker's lit. I am good at 100% sure. Feel fucked, but also feel amazing after this. Dues paid. Wow, that took a little piece of my nutsack away with it. Absolute fucking fire workout. That is a true test of some leg endurance. You'll fucking love it. If you really want to test your leg endurance, strength, capacity, you want to test some grit and some fucking resilience, do that workout, right? You got 100 barbell squats, okay? And every break, so when you fail in the you got hundreds of reps. Oh my God. Let's lie down. So you've got 100 reps of barbell squats. I did 90 kilos, okay? I did 20 reps each set, 25 times, okay? When you've broken on the squats, you're gonna go 20 dumbbell Bulgarian split squats. You got 25 kilo each arm, and then you got 400 meter runs, okay? I manage 20 reps each set on 90 kilos. You wanna try and be smart with this, because basically the more reps you do on the barbell squats, the less rounds. But with the more reps you do, you're gonna have to take your time for the other exercises in the workout. So yeah, 5 rounds, 20 reps on the barbell squats. That was a fucking really good workout. I hope you enjoyed it, guys. Give that a try. Please go for your body weight on the barbell squats. And I did 25 kilos each arm. But yeah, feeling really good at the minute. Defo, dropping the fat, getting lean, feeling healthy, feeling fit. I've ended up buying a oxygen machine, which is in the neck next to my bed. I went on it before. I'll tell you a little bit more about that in the YouTube videos. Phenomenal machine. I wanted it 5 years ago. It basically healed my injury. It's amazing for inflammation, brain health, heart health, fucking your stomach, your gut. It's fucking next level shit. And I thought one day, you know what? Instead of buying any material shit, let's be smart. If I can train heavier, if I can train harder, I can be in the gym more and recover faster, I'm gonna be a better motherfucking athlete, more of a leader, an inspiration for you guys, because you can see that relentlessness in the gym, in business, in life. So it's gonna improve on my sleep, it's gonna improve on my endurance in the bed, sexual performance, and also just help overall optimizing my body.
All right, guys, I'm gonna show you some updated information on the villas I'm building. If you don't already know, I'm investing in building some villas. This is such an exciting project. I can't wait. I've been holding back on investing in things, just putting money back into the business from day one. And I think now it's time to move forward into a different phase of my career, my business, my life, and that's building some villas out in Bali. And these are the villas. We've got six villas, we've got a bigger one at the end. It's overlooking rice fields. It's about 10 minutes down the beach from here. Things are moving further and further down the beach, basically, in Bali. Like, the amount of construction work, building going on is ridiculous. As I was mentioning, I can literally hear fucking building going on right now. And that's why I'm moving villas, it's so annoying. So, everyone's building. And I thought, for a long time, what am I gonna do with investing into things? Like, what am I gonna do? What am I gonna buy? I've not bought cars, I've not bought watches, I've bought health machines. Of course, I spend money on rent quite a lot, food, but everything else, mate, is pretty much standard. I just hold my money and then put it back into the business. So I've been saving up, and this is what I'm gonna be working on now, building six villas. I'm gonna take you through it and show you what it looks like at the moment. So yeah, here we go. So sick. What a vibe. You got the pool, you got the outdoor, you've actually got sunbeds here. This is gonna change from wood to a different type of stone. Change the wood. I love it so much. Two bedroom villas, I'm building six of them. This is the star, nice and bright. Got the skylights here, nice and bright again. Yeah, it's so cool. Such a good vibe. Like, what the fuck? How sick is this? So yeah, a little update on where I'm up to here, guys, with this. Do I know what I'm doing? Not really. What's the worst that could happen? I lose a little bit of money. I have to spend more money on it. I don't think it's that bad of a risk, really, to be honest, guys. Of course, I've gone down the route of buying the land through lawyers, a notary, so that's all boxed off and done. Now it's just time to get this boxed off and designed up right, and then we find the best builders we can do and build something good quality. So yeah, super excited, guys. And then even after I've done this, and however long it takes, it doesn't matter, I'm just gonna take my time with it. And then it's moving on to another project, really, where I see the business going and where I see myself really helping change and transform a lot of people, is like retreats. But I'm gonna build a facility where I can hold them. Everything I've tried to do, I do it on my own, and I take my time with it. And you get to a certain point, then you go to the next phase, the next part, the next segment of your life. And I've always got big goals, and then when I get to a point, I always think, oh, bigger. And then I go off into a different direction slightly. But yeah, I think for me, this is the best investment I can make at the moment, besides putting more money back into the business, which I do. I don't really fucking spend much money apart from rent and maybe some flights here and there, first class. But besides that, I'm fucking spending a lot of money on helping others. You know what I mean? So yeah, let's fucking go, guys.